together. Life. The sharp inhalation of breath, energy, air, soil, growth. Green leaves stretching towards the sun, rough wind whistling across jagged rocks. The dance of water, drip of freshly melted ice, the urgency of the hunt, the drive to thrive, survive, and grow. The wake left behind by the movement of magnificent creatures. The flash of speed, spark of life, erosion, exploration, innovation, expansion, growth. This is all life interconnected. Every creature's survival, our planet's very future made manifest through these dynamic connections. An interwoven complex web that surrounds and includes every creature, be it human, animal, environmental, each lockstep in a dance that has persisted through all time, nothing existing alone. The strengths of one enriching another, all suffering when one falls. This universal global dance of cause and effect, and cause and effect, interconnected lives, health, and being tied together, tightly woven into an intricate, delicate balance. Together, linked, whole, all one. One planet, one existence, one health, one future. Ours is a planet shared by many. A singular home to a richly diverse spectrum of life forms. All living in a solitary world where the impacts to one are shared by many. This interconnection between people, animals, and their shared environments is the foundation of what is known as One Health. One Health is a collaborative view of the world, interconnected, dependent, linked together.
One Health is the way the world works.
The blending of animal studies, human studies, and our ecosystem studies.
You do not look as this is an environmental issue only, this is an animal health issue only, this is a human health issue only, but really look at how are these things connected.
Nothing exists in a vacuum. All of these things have impacts on everything else, and you really need to look at the system as a whole.
To understand One Health view of the world, one has to understand the connection between all living things. Humans connected to animals, which are connected to the environment, which in return is connected back to the humans. Recognizing the interdependence of human, animal, and environmental health gives researchers the ability to view issues facing our planet through a wide lens, integrate multiple disciplines, and address root causes for problems by understanding the actual source of an issue.
In the scientific world and the medical world, we tend to work in silos. We tend to work within our own disease disciplines or areas of interest. And sometimes we don't know what we don't know. By using a One Health approach, we bring other people into the conversation that have other kinds of knowledge that can contribute to our understanding.
The tenets of One Health originated in the veterinary profession.
We began to realize that about 75% of the emerging infectious diseases in people were of zoonotic origin, which means that they came from animals. And so that's where the term One Health came from.
And a lot of the, especially infectious disease threats, are intimately related to changes in the land or the animals around people.
You actually have to prevent the disease in animals to prevent the disease in people. So you vaccinate dogs against rabies in order to protect people.
While One Health is a relatively new focus in scientific research, the concept is not a new one.
Indigenous people in Alaska have been using the concept of One Health for thousands of years. So they have always looked at the environment as a whole.
We have taken care of our environment for over 10,000 years.
My grandfather would often say, you know, when we take care of the land and we take care of the animals, they take care of us.
I think that as Westerners, we need to look at the world that way too, because whether we want to admit it or not, we're still part of an ecosystem. Whether you live in rural Alaska or downtown Anchorage or Manhattan, the environment that you live in influences your health, and you influence the health of your environment.
We are living on a planet with finite resources, and therefore need for us to understand a healthy and sustainable relationship between humanity and the natural environment, which includes the land and the animals that provide for our sustenance as human beings.
As the climate shifts globally, significant focus has turned to the Arctic, which is experiencing the most rapid effects of environmental change as more and more species fight for their survival in the midst of their rapidly changing world. The University of Alaska Fairbanks, or UAF, is America's leading climate change and Arctic research institution, working collaboratively across the university system and with external partners throughout the globe. As the science around climate change has evolved, the university has established the Center for One Health Research, leading the way in the multidisciplinary approach for the circumpolar north.
The University of Alaska, the Fairbanks campus in particular, really is, it's galvanizing this new emphasis on health issues.
This is more or less ground zero for changes that are happening in the environment.
Changes that are happening around the world are happening faster here, and so I think UAF is the perfect university, really, to start this One Health initiative.
In today's swiftly changing environment, utilizing a holistic One Health approach is absolutely vital.
The One Health initiative is really fabulous for the university to have picked up that ball and run with it.
We live and breathe Arctic issues. Climate change is affecting the Arctic at a faster rate than anywhere else on the planet, and we're here to witness it. We're here to study it.
What's happening here is going to happen other places. We're just seeing it earlier and to a more dramatic degree.
So the question that emerges is, what can be done as we anticipate the changes that are coming along in the environment that are in turn going to affect the ecosystems and people.
And that's an important aspect of One Health, is that it provides us with a very helpful framework, not just how do we adapt, but how do we mitigate, how do we respond. And the fact that we're seeing so much larger changes here than in many other parts of the globe puts us in a position where, on the one hand, we're challenged, but on the other hand, we have an opportunity by bringing together experts here at the university, bringing together indigenous knowledge holders and experts out in rural Alaska, bringing together the best that technology and industry, the private sector, have to offer to help us think through how do we best respond.
And I think that is a question of global concern, and is going to require humanity to be coming closer together. And really, the approach we're taking here, we call it interdisciplinary, but it's also intercultural, and bringing together different worldviews and perspectives and understanding and knowledge systems to help contribute to this conversation of how do we come together in a way that's going to produce positive and sustainable outcomes for the health and well-being within humanity.